Can you ask McMillan, what our, guys, can you quit sword fighting? Can you,
Woo, it's a scary episode. We should have done this for Halloween. Hey guys, welcome back to VTV.
Hi.
This week we're doing it standing.
We're doing it standing, but and to bring that in, we're gonna have the man himself who made it tell you about it. Matthew.
Oh my God.
Hey, me and Corey go around and ask you what makes you happy.
What makes me happy?
Yes.
Saving the planet. No, I love it, actually. That's my favorite
that
thing.
Makes you happy?
Yeah, I would say saving the planet makes me happy.
Makes me happy. Just being alive makes me happy.
My mommy.
Going to bed at 8:30 makes me happy.
Your mom.
My doggy. My doggy makes me happy.
Seeing other people happy.
Listening to music.
What makes you happy?
Geometry.
I don't know.
Wow, bro. He's sitting right there.
Yeah, not him.
Right now it's not her, so we're good.
Chick-fil-A.
Food. That's it.
That's it.
I like eyelashes too. And lip gloss. And earrings.
The good Lord up above and the people that surrounding me makes me happy. You guys makes me happy.
Thank you.
What makes you happy?
Yeah.
Not waking up in the morning. Being able to sleep in.
What makes you happy?
My baby.
I'm not supposed to
what
follow that.
Happy? Seriously?
I have to follow after that?
Yes.
All my 8 babies.
My mama?
My dog makes me happy.
What makes you happy?
What makes me happy? I don't know, man. Sleeping?
My family, mainly.
Is she happy?
Food.
Smiling faces.
What makes me happy? Family. Getting to see my kids. Makes you guys happy?
Day. What makes me happy?
Yeah.
Life.
My family.
Video games.
My children and my family make me very, very happy. And seeing the success of our students here on our campus makes me really happy.
Kind people on the beach.
Being alive, but my little granddaughter, Tatum Joanne Pittman, makes me happy.
Have you ever woke up and then, you know, you like when you're eating that night, you was eating some spaghetti, right? And you just left it there and you went to sleep and you wake up and you like, dang, I'm hungry. And you look to the left and you see that bowl of spaghetti. I mean, it's a little bit old, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, it's still good, you know what I'm saying? Because you're hungry.
Wait, 3 in the morning.
You know when you wake up and you look at the clock and you're glad you still got like another 2 hours of sleep left?
That's the time.
Wow, that was an amazing video. You're welcome. Now, next, we have teacher volleys.
Thank you.
Drama to me just means happiness and joy. Anytime we do a show, anytime we do competition or anything like that, all your castmates and yourself just find a great deal of joy and friendships that you can make through it. Faculty volleys is a great way to see your teachers either embarrass themselves or have a great shining moment and have a talent that you never knew they had. It's a great way to see them in a whole new different light. All money goes to the theater department to help with any type of competitions or to put on another show like this again. Everyone performing is any type of faculty member at Fort Walton Beach High School.
Thank you.
Okay,
good to go.
Ooh.
Thank you.
Volleyball?
Don't
Thanks,
know what that
Matt.
Is.
And that was our special guest, Matthew.
Hope you all are enjoying this video.
I hope you enjoy Matthew.
Next video, we gotta do some weightlifting.
Who made that one?
I don't know.
Hi, I'm Sydney. I'm a senior and I do weightlifting. I have been doing weightlifting since I was in seventh grade. I love weightlifting so much because for so long, I've had so much going on in my life, and the only thing that has been a constant the whole time has been weightlifting. When we're training, we do a bunch of different stuff, just a lot of different lifts, different ways to do the lifts. We practice technique a lot. We do a lot of heavyweight stuff to try and get higher weights. The hardest part of it all is when you're in a meet and you're the only person on the platform and the only, like, the judge is right there sitting right in front of you and trying to block out everything and, like, it just be you so that you don't mess it up. My favorite part about weightlifting mostly is getting a new coach this year, or last year, because every year we had a different coach up until last year, but he stayed with us for my senior year too. I think he's gonna stay with us for a while. And also winning regionals, that was fun. Our sport is like one of the only sport that I played that's just been all girls that doesn't have any drama. Like most female sports have a lot of drama and this one has none. And I love the girls and everybody, so. When you're lifting and you don't have any support or anybody like yelling for you to like get up the weight or do good, then it's harder to do, but when you have that support behind you, it's a lot easier. So I think that's what makes it so much easier for us to have no drama and just be really close together. Woohoo! Cut!
That's it. But I'm gonna put in, you know, people park in the teacher parking lot, and I feel like I started that revolution. Like, I definitely did, and now everybody does it. So now I had to make a video on why you shouldn't.
Hello, my name is Josh.
I'm Darian.
And we're shedding light on a topic that is tossed around.
It hurts.
So enjoy this little skit of not parking in the teacher parking lot.
It's bad.
We're two kids who really want to go to school today. Wow, but we have to park our car somewhere. Look, where should we do it?
There's no parking space.
No. I can't believe I almost did that, dude. Oh my god.
Maybe that one?
Okay, I'll park that. Oh, no, wait. Dude, that's such a far walk. Wait a second. What's this? Faculty and visitor parking. Do you see that?
I think it's perfect.
Dude, it's so close to the front of the school. Oh my god, dude. This is awesome.
Let's go to school now.
Let's go to school now. Dude, we made it to school. Look at this. That's my phone. All right. Let's go to school now. And that is what people do. Can you believe those people? Can you believe that? Whoever is the owner of that red Jeep, imagine.
Wait. Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
All right, and that's it. Okay, that's truly all we have for this week. See ya.
Peace out.